I like to make light and generate the wound. Build them up and let them fall. Just lay your mound and leave the real name. Generate and lay your flat like a monkey man. Leave them built, rock stand and tight and now it's like. Mix every single one he could ever need. A bar of speed. Let Fred Stone, Fred Stone lie. Let's take, let's feel wanted. Boris knows, and Boris, he likes it all. He's like,
it's a killer, she's a killer maker. He reaches in and takes from the back of your. see the light. I gotta smile, got what they call a lot. I like a halfway good, but it's on my own. I say I can't, but I really mean I won't. In the arm, or maybe up the nose, I see it. Boris, he has a way of seeing through my eyes. He touches in a fashion, a master of mine, manipulating me, my arms and legs and spine. He's got sinking through the way, straight on through. Let him I could have been gone for more. Held up in the intensive care ward, lying on the floor. I was gone for all those days, but I was not all alone. I made friends with a lot of people in the danger zone. Some weight there, and I really need some rest. Sleeping don't come very easy in a straight white vest. Should like to see that children, she's only
for you, so I'd give the back all of the plaything, even ones I stole. See my lonely life unfold. I see it every day. See my lonely mind explode when I've gone insane.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for coming out. This is great.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You all look beautiful.
You look great.
Yeah, of course. Anyway, what I'm going to do is a comment, other than the last song, which I didn't write, everybody likes the coop, right?
I wish I wrote that song.
That's a good song. It's a feel-good number. Rock and roll number. Alice is good for that. Feel-good songs, kill yourself, kill everyone else. But, you know, like he said, we were driving a stake through the heart of the peace and love generation.
Yeah.
Mission accomplished. Anyway. What I'm going to do is a combination of new songs that I wrote specifically for the acoustic and old Melvin songs that I wrote, some on acoustic, but most of which went straight to the band, and I played them on electric. So it's a combination of those songs. There's not a lot of difference. My wife says it sounds the same to her. She's always good for that kind of thing, too. Speaking of driving a stake through the heart of the piece of electric. That's great. I'm not doing another show here, so this is really cool. I'm glad you guys were able to come out, and I'm glad everybody here was able to be so cool. Thank you guys so much.
Yeah.
So this is a new thing for me, so remember, I'm going to make a deal. I've made a deal with everybody so far on the few shows I've played that when I screw up a song, I'm just going to play it over. So I don't want to hear any complaining later about that, okay?
Don't worry.
You didn't get ripped off because you didn't pay nothing. Since you didn't pay nothing. You have no say in what goes on stage. Good, good, good. So we understand, right? We understand. So I'm going to play my favorite song off the New Dude Boots record. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you.
this little animal way up in the air. My nose and tongue are roving, but maybe it's not there. There's a little man now in the middle of the earth. He gives himself these orders and let it all be burned. There are lots of makeshift wonders, seven in the world. Five of them will not be noticed, that we will not be heard. There's a face that you can see. You can keep what you've stolen, just give it back to me. I vow to take my vengeance, even when they're dead. He knows his time is over, and maybe he's better off.
Pardon me while I switch to an avant-garde tuning, or as we like to call it, an Ava Gardner tuning. You guys know what that means, right? For sure. Ava Gardner? I'll take that as a yes. So anyway, I have a new 10-inch out. He's going right there. There it is. It's one of the last ones. It's called This Machine Kills Artists. I think you guys know what that means, right?
Yes.
I'll take that as a yes. You guys are so agreeable. I love it. If you just say nothing, I'll take it as a yes. Always. Okay? Play a couple songs off that, okay? Okay? Okay. Thank you.
sure of my mind in speech. I wanna say thank you to all my friends. I won't complain about beginnings and ends. Bare bones inside a bloodless
I'm going to tell you a long, semi-interesting, yet still pointless story, okay?
No.
No?
Well, I don't care, I'm going to do it anyway. You got mine, do you? I'm sure you have a lot of choices. What is it, six? What could you be doing right now? What would you normally be doing at six? You, right there.
Rush hour traffic?
This is better than rush hour traffic, maybe. Yeah. Hey, can we open that door? Is that possible?
Evan.
Do it.
Open the door.
Oh, thank you.
Evan.
It's a little right, you guys think? Yeah. Woo, woo-wee, baby.
What are you sex?
Boy, am I glad I'm not doing this in August here.
Oh, man. Try July.
Anyway, this is a story about how I blew it. I totally blew it. I'm going to try to watch my language because there's probably kids here and I don't want to be a total... Well, I almost said it. A total jerk. There, is that better? Kids can handle jerk, right?
Everybody knows what a jerk is, right?
Steve Martin.
I'm not paid to be a jerk, though. I think he's an even bigger jerk now. Yeah. So I've heard.
Word on the street.
But anyway, so I used to be friends with Dave Grohl. You guys know who Dave Grohl is, right? I'll take that as a yes.
Going there. Damn it.
I knew Dave when he was in, a long time ago, when he was in a band called Scream. But I knew Scream, the band Scream, before that. In the early 80s, they put out a record on Discord that I still think is the best record that Discord ever put out. And I was a big fan of that record. I saw them play a few times with the original lineup. And then the original drummer went on tour. So the story goes from Dave, my old friend Dave. Remember, this is all leading up to me blowing it big time. Okay. I heard that they got back from the tour, and his 2-year-old kid didn't have any idea who he was, the drummer. Just, he's like, my kid doesn't even know who I am. I can't go on tour anymore, so he quit. Enter Dave. Dave's a penniless, it's rags to riches story for sure.
Came without warning.
The main streets of D.C. Anyway, Dave was a young kid, you know, playing drums, a real good drummer. And so then the Melvins played with Scream a number of times after that, and that's where we met Dave. So I was friends with Dave for a long time before, let's just say, before he could buy cars with a credit card. I knew Dave B.C. before credit and before Cobain. How about that? So, anyway, Dave becomes this big superstar later up here, playing the QE Arena and other non-venues, you know. I don't consider anywhere built for a sporting event to be a venue to see music. I don't know if you guys do, but if I go to a hockey arena, I want to see hockey.
Yes.
I don't want to see a band play. I don't know. That's what I liked about punk rock to begin with. I liked the intimacy of the whole thing. That's what attracted me to it. You really don't get that in a place that's designed for basketball. I mean, if you're 16 and you're on acid or something, it's fun to just be away from your parents for a long period of time. So it has its place. I understand that. It's not that I don't get it, you know. But as time has went on, you know, and I... Relatively quickly, when I was a young kid, I realized that I wanted to go to places like this or a regular club and see the bands right in the eyes. You know, that's what I liked. Anyway, so Dave's playing venues that you can barely see him with a deer rifle. You know, I think it's him. Could be a roadie. You know. And it reminds me quickly. I saw the Rolling Stones in the early '80s.
Bummer.
In a non-venue. I've been to
this guy.
You don't like the Beatles either,
or
right?
The early
no.
80s.
How can you not like... I don't like one single song the Stones ever did. You don't like them. Not one
that.
Song.
I didn't say that.
You said you didn't like them.
You're really going to argue with this man.
Well, I like the Stones. I don't know about you guys. I'm up to about the mid-70s. I really like... I love the Stones. I thought they were great. Anyway, so I go to this non-venue to see the Stones, and it would literally be halfway through a song before I'd go... Oh, it's Satisfaction. It literally amplified motocross in a place like that. You know? It's like, you know, it's not for me. Anyway, Dave's playing places that sound like amplified motocross, you know, and we're playing, you know, we're down here, Dave's up here, so I lost track of Dave, you know, believe it or not. Okay, so Dave doesn't have time, and when you get that big, phones quit working both ways. Do you guys know that? They no longer work back and forth. So anyway, I've lost track of Dave for well over a decade, you know. All of a sudden I see in the LA paper, which is where I live, the original Scream's going to play a show in LA. Wow, I'm going to go. That'll be great. The original lineup, that'll be really fun. I can't wait to go, you know. So I go to the show. It's in a venue, not a non-venue, okay, which is exciting enough as it is. Who's at the show but Dave? My old buddy Dave. Dave's really happy, acts like he's really happy to see me. How's it going? Give me your number, blah, blah, blah. Changing numbers back and forth, me and Dave. Okay, the show's great, by the way, you know. Anyway. So a week or so later, I text Dave. Nothing. Text him again. Nothing. Put the phone away and quit texting Dave after that. Okay. Dave doesn't text me back, so, all right, I get the picture. No worries, you know, so, nothing new, nothing's changed, okay, fine. Whatever. So, a while goes by, all of a sudden, I'm in my kitchen with my wife, and the phone rings, it's Dave. Dave's calling me on my phone. I can see it, because it's still in my phone, it tells me, you know. Dave calling, you know, so, I better answer it, hello, you know. Hey, it's Dave. I act surprised. You know? He goes, listen, I'm in this other band called Them Crooked Vultures. I was vaguely aware of that, you know. Not super aware of it. I mean, I hadn't heard any of it, but I knew he was in a band with a guy from Led Zeppelin and somebody else, and I don't know. And he goes, listen, we're playing a big show in L.A. at some venue or non-venue, I'm not sure which. And he goes, I want you to come down and be my special guest. Remember, this is how I blew it. Okay. I want you to come down and be my VIP guest. Backstage, you can come backstage and meet John Paul Jones, a guy from Led Zeppelin. I'm imagining wow, I could be doing blow with him. I could, you know, who knows what? Maybe we could end up in Mexico. Lord only knows. That guy's got deep pockets. We could do whatever we wanted. You know, anyway, come on down. It'll be great. And here's where I blow it. My wife's listening to the whole conversation. And by the way, at the end of this, at the end of the conversation when I hung up, she said, "You're the only person in the world that would have done that." Okay, bear that in mind. Okay, that's what she told me after I hung up with Dave. I go, "Dave, what day's that show?" He tells me the date, and I go, "Oh, man, I got Dodger tickets that night."
Dodger.
And they weren't even good tickets. And then I said, "If something happens, I'd be more than happy to have you come with me to the game." And he never called me again. And then my wife said, "You're the only person." Anyway, I told you it was a relatively pointless story. You like it?
Yeah! So I got a couple more. Thank you guys. Thank you guys for coming. Thank you so much.
Right now.
you. Yeah. I don't remember how exactly I got the idea to play live acoustically, but nonetheless, there it is. I remember when I was worrying over it, my wife tells me, she goes, look, she's a very wise woman. There's one thing I've learned after 20 years of marriage is that I don't know anything about women. I know less about them now. I think if you approach it like that, you're going to be just fine. Everything will be fine. You know, they're different than us, and that is good because I could not live with anyone that's like me. Absolutely not. That would be. I would kill myself. Kill him and me next. Anyway, I couldn't make that work. You know, and I realized relatively quickly that women that were willing to put up with me and my eccentric nature and what I do for a living, those women don't grow on trees. I better make this work. So I listen. Generally, if I'm smart, I'll listen to what she says. So I was worrying over this, and she goes, just play and act like you do in our living room when you're playing acoustic guitar. I walk around just like this, stupidly. The only difference is there's no dog over here on the couch for me to pet. There should be. You know, they never judge me. So anyway, thanks for coming. I got one more song, and I'll see you next time.
Yeah.
Took a big green
days and I won't forget it. Minute old monster tower, now you won't need it.
Thank you.
Yeah.